It's working, I think it's working. Hello everyone. Yes, it's working. Hello, Kim Bong. Oh, I'm so ruining your name. Kim Bong Un? Is that the right pronunciation? it's working. So hope you guys had a awesome Christmas and a nice Boxing Day yesterday. Yes. Hello, RC Modeling or Armor. Jesus. RC Armor. Okay. What did I get for Christmas? This thing. And a Flock 40, Swilling Flock, all BS of course. Oh, I had a great Christmas RC Armor. I had a lot to drink and I'm still feeling it right now. I had a bit too much to drink, I think. Yeah. Oh, I got some goodies, all right. I see armor. I got some kits from Model Collect. Some new kits. It's the one with the F1 rocket on it, the missile launcher. Now, these, of course, were never made by Germany or designed by Germany. They're all fictional. And I got a Feinmold's Girls und Panzer. I forgot the name of this tank. I have no idea what what the name of this tank is. It's not the Honey, that's the self-propelled gun. And since I can't read the Japanese, I have no idea. It doesn't say anywhere. Oh, whoa. It's the Type 98. It's the Type 98, but yeah. What's the official name? I know that a lot of you guys hate Girls and Panzer, but I love Girls and Panzer, so yeah. I am not going to paint it in the Girls and Panzer style. I'm going to just paint it in a Japanese variant that was in China at the time. And I got some more Girls and Panzer stuff. Some small figurines. First, let's have a look at the V1. The German V1 missile launcher with E-100 body. Whoa. Those are some crooked tracks. And of course, I already had a small look at these, but Jesus. Oh my God. Are they supposed to be this crappy? Hello, flames are up. Did you have a nice Christmas? Oh my God, these are bad. Ja, happy face. Ik kijk naar al de berichten, ja. die soort. Wow, you really need to do a lot of weathering to this to make it even look okay. I think there are final tracks. Yeah, rubbery tracks, but yeah. Do you guys see this? Look at that. Look at this. And the same here. It's all crooked. I have no idea what's up with those, but yeah. They're not really that great. Still going to have a lot of fun building it, but yeah. I'm not going to build it right now. Yeah, it's really weird that there are crooked like that. This, oh, don't they have quality control or something? That's, now I'm curious. Now I want to see the other one. Oh, the black. My lordy. Oh, and what an airbrush, that's nice. And a few Dragon Kids, British modeler. Okay. Which kits did you get? C modeler. These are the same way. Don't know if you can see that because it's black on black. So yeah. But these are crooked as well. These are crooked. Look at those. So they're probably not been heated or something went wrong with these two, but both kits have the same problem, and this is even a different color, and it still has the same crooked ass tracks. I think I have an Iwata airbrush. I have no idea what the what the maker of my airbrush is, but I think I have an Iwata, and there are great airbrushes. Okay, that's a bit disappointing. The ancient deck I'm going to remove these from the packaging. The rest of the parts are not even in plastic. But okay. That's really odd. This is really odd packaging. Half of it is in plastic bags and half of it is not in plastic bags. A British scale modeler, oh, a Panzer 3, you got a Tiger with Cimarit, a Sherman Firefly, and a mouse. On a Sherman and a mouse. Oh, I don't know, that's nice. Tiger with Cimarit and a Sherman Firefly. You can deliver them at my P.O. box. This looks okay. I like the detail on this. Okay, I can live with that. I use the V1 rocket. Yeah, the sprues seem okay. Some nice detail on it. Yeah, the sprues are okay. There's some really nice detail on them. So yeah, I can live with that. Sadly, the The tracks are a bit warped, but yeah. Some photo etch parts, some decals, some weird choice of decals, but okay. Some more rocket parts. And this is a different rocket right here. Some bottom of a flag, so probably parts from a different kit with a different rocket on there. I wonder what that rocket is. Do you guys know what for rocket this is? I have no idea. Probably fictional or something. Doesn't look like anything German to me, but what do I know? Some more parts of the bottom of that rocket launcher. Some crates, and they really need to check their quality control. They're on 172 scale. Model kits fit together quite well, you say, British modeler. Okay, I hope you're right. Their quality control seems to be lacking to me. Look at this, there is stains on here. Are there plastic stains from other sort of molded plastic? Yeah, I'm not bothered by this. It doesn't affect the kit much. There are plastic stains on there, but yeah, it's not really great quality control. And are they really going to place a history on this? Yeah. Garot 383 or TG01. So that's a bullshit number right there, but okay. Was a German super heavy tank design developed near the end of World War II. It was also be the basis for heavy artillery systems and anti-aircraft vehicles. Yeah, that's bullshit. And a heavy tank destroyer, that's also bullshit. The development of these last was never started due to the end of the war, but which time only the E-100 chassis was partially completed. Yeah, that's a lot of bullshit right there. The E-100 project was never developed any further. It should have a mouse turret at some point, but they changed that because it became too heavy. And because of the failure of the mouse project, they changed many things about the E-100, because the mouse had a lot of problems with weight. When it drove around, it just destroyed its own road wheels. It had many breakdowns because of this. And the people that were working on the E-100 project saw this and acknowledged these problems. So they went with a different turret. And that's all the E-100 series went through. There was no design or anything else of any anti-aircraft vehicles or even anti-tank vehicle. That's all made up after the war. Was never designed, never developed, never went any further than this. Even this whole thing is just one block of BS. Why would you even stick a V1 rocket on such a big tank? it's a waste of resources. You shoot the V1, and what do you want to do with the rest of this tank after you shoot the V1? Even the V1 launch platform was super long, so that the whole V1 could not even launch from this small thing. But still, it's a lot of fun. It's just stupid fun to make a tank like this. That's the parts. V1 is going to be assembled first. The engine, it even has an engine for such a small tank. It's the launcher platform. Some more of the road hill works. It's pretty easy. Some more of the engine. More engine bits on the backside. The weird warped tracks are going to be on there. And then the side armor. I really wanted to do the side armor. I wanted to cut these in half and have this plate of side armor on there and this plate of side armor. But because the tracks are so warped like they are, I don't know if I want to do that anymore. Maybe with some camouflaging, some mud on the tracks, you can make them look better. But yeah, that's a bit sad. So yeah, for the people that just tuned in here, I'm talking about these tracks. They're all warped. They're not straight anymore. So yeah. And if you think, okay, it's only this kit I have. No, I have a second kit, and it has the same problem. Okay, when you're done here, you're going to place it on there. And that's it. Some camouflage schemes. No, I'm not going to camouflage it. I think I'm only going to do it in rust color and maybe paint this in German gray. And then the V1 rocket in the colors that are represented right here. And that's it. Maybe do some other bits on there. Some other fun stuff. Some different colors for the... For some different rust colors or different iron and all that sort of stuff. Going to be real fun building this. Yeah, that's a bit disappointing. The engine deck. Bottom of the tank, the hatches, an MG. For all the detail they place into these things, the MG's detail is really lacking. Man, cannot have everything. Also get two upper hulls. It's probably because this is the original mouse hull, and this is of an E100 hull, and this is the normal for this kit. Tommy, okay, you recently finished building the Molecolex E100, and it had some major flaws, like the driver's hatches are flipped. Okay. And also trimmed off two of the blocks in the hull for the suspension. Okay. I don't know. Yeah, I think I see the driver's hatches are flipped. Okay. That's another thing I have to look at then. The side armor plates here and the side armor here. Here's the engine. The back, no, back bit or the front bit of the engine parts. The wheels. Detail looks pretty good on these. I like it. No, I'm probably not going to change anything on the flaws on this kit. I'm just going to build it because it's just a fictional thing at best. Okay, have a look at the other kit. These are the other warp tracks I told you guys about. They're not really that great. There's the wheels again. And the other bits and bobs. The packaging is so odd in these kits. That's in packaging. In that box it was not in packaging. This is also not in packaging. And this is also in a really odd bag. A different bag to the other one. This sort of bag, and this is this sort of bag. Yeah. I'm going to have something to cut this open. Yeah, of course. I don't have anything to cut it open. Hi, Alawi Civic. You're from Poland. I'm from the Netherlands. Some more bits here for the flock gun. Some other bits here. So it wasn't too difficult to fix the hatches, Tommy. Okay, I have to have a look into that and what I'm going to do with those hatches. Some shells here and some other parts. Okay, more parts of the flock. The base of the flock. Okay. And this one also comes with PA parts. Photo etch stuff. And the same decals. Ah, that doesn't matter, Alawi Civic. Not everybody is good in English. I'm not really that great in English, but yeah. Here's the flock assembly. Okay, start from the beginning. Yeah, you start with the flock assembly. So I have more of the flock. More flock. And the other side is the tank itself. The engine. Just the same as the other kit. many tracks again, and on the side armor, place the side armor at the top on there, and then the flock. Yes, Jeremy, it's 172 scale. And here is the paint scheme. Dark yellow, and this is camouflage with German gray. I'm probably going to do it German gray, the flock, and then the rest I'm going to do... I'm going to paint it in rust color, like the other one. Maybe the tracks with some camouflage on there, some different parts. Maybe the hatches have been painted. Maybe the wheels have some color on them, some of them. Because the Germans really had a paint problem. So yeah, because they had really a shortage of paint and other stuff at the end of the war, so yeah. Probably going to do something like that. The mouse dragon kit, that's a really old kit, isn't it? I think the other company, the Techcom or something, brought out a new mouse kit. Still, Dragon makes great kits. A lot of people hate Dragon, but I enjoy Dragon really, really well. It always fits great, and I really have no problems with Dragon. But yeah. Let's have a look at the girls in Panzer one. That's crap. Here, some anime stuff. Hi, Loki. Hey. Why are you sitting there, kitty kitty? Always needs to be in the video. Always. You need to always bother me, Loki, Loki. What's your problem? When I'm modeling, he always needs to have a look at everything. Yeah, they really must found it in in some old modeling shop under a pile of dust or something, because that mouse kit is pretty rare. It's not out of production per se. They still make it for the girls and Panzer kits. I don't know, Carlos. It's probably piece based, so I think you have the plastic tracks. Or the rubber tracks are much cheaper to produce, so I think the kits with rubber tracks are much more are cheaper than the normal ones. Yes, it's anime. Yeah, the instructions begins with some manga or something. I've no idea what it says because I don't read kanji. Is this kanji or katakana? I have no idea. So yeah, more instructions to assemble the tank. It's probably an old dragon kit or fine mods kit. Yeah, this is an old fine mods kit. Dragon never made this type of tank. Yeah, das ist ein toller Anime, World War II. Some BA parts are included as well. Loki, serieus, ga verwieberen. Stupid cat. Some more PA parts. The gun assembly. And the turret assembly. But yeah, if you guys have some questions, feel free to ask. Some more turret assembly. This is probably the decal that goes over here, but I'm not going to place the decal. Favorite tank, the Panzer, and Japanese tanks in general. I really love the look of the Argo, the Japanese Argo tank. Something about that tank I really love. The wheel assembly right here, or the bogey assembly, the side armor. All these tanks from this time have a specific look to them. Somehow they really didn't want the sand or other stuff to fall on the wheel bogies at some point, because a lot of these tanks from this time period had this sort of build up. The Valentine, the Matilda had this, the Char B had it, the Churchill had it. And here's the decals for the volleyball team, all the volleyballs on there. The other volleyball, I have no idea what this of course says, but yeah, it probably says that it's the volleyball team. Yeah. And this is the later version. Yeah, here says the game version, but I have no idea what that means. Vehicle discovery version. The discovery version is probably the first version they have in the series when they find this tank. The Matilda is a really nice tank, yeah. Now it looks awesome. When I played World of Tanks, I always played with the Matilda. I really love that tank. Some decals with the goals on there from the volleyball team. The other stickers, all the volleyballs right here. The logo for their school. And their team logo. No idea what this team is called. No, the main team is the Anglo Fish, but I have no idea what this team is called. Some of the parts, the turret, the gun barrels, of course, in two halves. The wheels, all the bogies and all that sort of thing, the return rollers. There's sort of an interior to this tank, but not really. There's a deck plate here. You can place the front door open and closed. More of the below the hull. The tracks are rubber. They're okay, I guess. They're not that bad. Seen burst tracks. Rubber tracks. Fimals is not an awful kit producer. I think they're better than Dragon at some some point for some reason. It's not really a model company you can easily get kits from in Europe. I think they're only selling to America. Maybe in Hong Kong. You can get them in Hong Kong, but okay, this looks really fun to build. Can't wait starting on this kit. If you guys want to have I can have a look at every single sprue if you guys really want that, but yeah. If not, I'm going to place it back into the box. What's up, Buzz Bomb Gaming and Guns? How are you doing? My grandpa drove a Matilda in France 1940, then again in the desert, then a Churchill until the Korean War. I did not know they used Matildas in France in 1940. You can buy an iron version of that, a brass version of that crappy gun. The two halves of that gun. I don't like guns that are molded in two halves. It leaves an annoying line and you have to file it. It never really looks that great. Yeah, more grills and Panzer. I got these. They're supposedly go with a bigger tank. You can place all these grills on there. They're sort of blind bags. Blind bag boxes, but you can buy them all together in one box, so you don't have to go to that blind bag nonsense. Only 20 Matilda tanks were used in France. Okay, I did not know that. That's really interesting. I thought they only were used in the desert. Let's have a look-see. Oh, that's one of the girls. Yes, girls and Panzer. It comes with a stand and other stuff. Oh, have a look at this. Where are the scissors of justice? I have no idea where I placed them. Ooh, scissors. Scissors of Destiny. Crap. I misplaced my scissors. I'm very interested. Japanese armor. The Yuga and Hago are very interesting. Yeah, same for me. I love Japanese armor. I'm glad that Dragon is making a lot of these Japanese armor kits because, yeah. The old ones from Tamiya are not that great, and fine molds, it's impossible to get here in Europe. And if you find a fine mold kit, it's overly expensive. I bought a truck here in the Netherlands, and it was maybe 50 euros. And if you buy that kit in Hong Kong or in China or in Tokyo, it's maybe 20 euros. So it's really ridiculous, overpriced. Where are the scissors? Scissors of justice. So yes, everyone, I hope you had a great Christmas. This is everything I got for Christmas. I'm a liar. I had a PlayStation 4. I got a PlayStation 4. some sticky shit on here. Everything is from loose bits. Maybe it's because you can place these figures in a Panzer IV tank. Oh, I did not know that they lined the inside of the Argo tank with asbestos. What? That's a British modeler. Okay, used. Okay, that's. Okay, I did not know that. How can I get this off? Get this plastic off. Get off. Oh, this isn't annoying. There she is. With the Anglerfish logo on the back. Oh, that's cute. I love cute things like that. No, many people hate it. They despise Girls of Tanks. But I'm not many people. So, this goes in here. And this goes in here. Now, go. You can move the arms. But yeah, that's about everything. You can move the head a little bit. So yeah, that's really cute. I had a great 2 days here. I drank a lot yesterday. And I'm still feeling it now. So yeah, have a look in this one. These are the blind bags, or blind boxes. You can buy in Japan, and I just bought the whole box with all the figures in him. Is this the sleepy girl? No, that one of them is the sleepy girl. I think this is a sleepy girl, right? For you people that watch Girls and Panzer. So I watched the movie and I watched the whole series, but they're so misshapen in this form. In this Funko Pop form. And I hate Funko Pops. But this, the anime figures, I get why you do this with anime figures. I don't get it why you do this with Star Wars characters. I get it. I get the stormtroopers. Okay. But the rest of the figures are horrible. All Funko Pop figures are horrible. Especially the human ones. This also comes with a stand. I'm not going to open all of them because it will be boring. have a look at the other one. So you buy from Japan. I always buy from Hobbylink. I'm not going to buy anymore in the Netherlands because it's overpriced. It's not worth it. Look at the other one. Yeah, it's almost an hour of stream now, so I'm going to shut it off soon. So quickly have a look at this. That's the main girl. She has the headset and everything. Here's the headset. She already has the ears here. And a stand, of course. So you could place them next to the other girls. Yeah, that's a lot of girls and Panzer stuff. If you're just new to the stream, I had a lot of stuff. Not only girls and Panzer for Christmas and Boxing Day yesterday. I had a PlayStation 4. No. I had some other kits from Model Collect. This one with a V1 rocket on a E100 tank. Totally fictional, of course. So, Loki! Loki! Look to all the. Say hello to all the people. Or yawn, that's also okay. Loki, hey. Oh, now you leave. You disappoint me, cat. But this is the other one. It's a Flak 40 on a E100. And interesting to know, the Flak 40s were of course built, not in this state, but they were placed on those big gigantic Flakturms. If you don't know what a Flakturm is, it's a gigantic bunker. And they were gigantic. They had four of those Flak 40s on top of them and some other Flak guns. There were a few in Berlin and in Hamburg. And if you remember Medal of Honor, there was a mission in Medal of Honor. At least I think it was Medal of Honor. And you had to take over one of those Flak towers. And I think there is a new game out. I forgot the name of that game. But there's an online map and there's also a Flak tower in this one. Now this is a sleepy girl, it must be. She looks really, really high. So this is a sleepy girl. With a stand, of course. Long hair. How can you go to attach the stand? Now you can pull the hair back. So you have to place the stand at the back of the hair or something. It's going to be a little fiddly, I guess. The stand is different than the other ones. That's going to be something. Yeah, Medal of Honor Airborne, that was the game. It was on the PlayStation 3. I think I still have that game somewhere. I must have the game somewhere. It was a really crap game. That's what I remember from it. just terrible to play, boring as hell. The only good thing about that game is the music. That's another thing. Why does game music suck so much these days? Battlefield 1. Shit music. Call of Duty World War 2. Shit music. Also shit game, but yeah. Still shit. Oh, this is a nice one. It's the other girl. They're all the other girls. Except it's the commander girl. The other one is the sleepy girl. I have no idea what they're called. What their names are. I think they did Call of Duty. I think the last Call of Duty I played was World at War, and then Ghost or something? I have no idea. After World at War, I just got tired of it. I didn't play it anymore. I got sick and tired of it. It was stupid. It was all fictional. It's really terrible. And Black Ops was the last Call of Duty I played. So, yeah. But, yeah, I hope you enjoyed this stream. If you have still some questions to ask away, or if you don't have any questions, I'm going to log off. So then I'm done here. I'm going to start my dinner. And then maybe drink some more beer. I really need a beer. I got some great beer right here. If you didn't know yet, I'm in the kitchen. Yeah. It's left over from yesterday. The La Trappa. Bokbier. 7%. It's not even the political correctness that bothers me about Call of Duty World War II. And I got more Bock Brandbier. So yeah, I'm going to enjoy those beers tonight. It's almost 6 o'clock, almost dinner time. Merry Christmas to you too, Jerry. But yeah, like I was saying, it's not the political correctness that bothers me about Call of Duty World War II. It's the old gameplay. It's not really that great. It's derivative, and it's not really exciting. It's the shooting, dying, shooting, dying, shooting, dying. It's like Star Wars Battlefront. It's that terrible. I'm not even kidding. And even the single player is. It's like Michael Bay thinks what World War II is like. It's that horrible. I at least in my opinion, it's that horrible. Everything is chaos in that game. It's Panzer IV tanks that rush in like idiots. And other tanks that rush in. Planes overhead, bombing where the airborne units are, and I'm talking about that specific Battle of the Bulge mission now, and it's just horrible. It's all chaos. There's not a single gameplay value in there that lets you play strategically. It's horrible. I like the gameplay in World at War. It had some more, it had some more options to play strategically and place your play. You didn't have to play so rushed, and in the new World War II Call of Duty, you have to play so rushed. Everything is fast, fast, fast. Explosion, bomb, boom, bam, bam, bam. Shoot that one, die, go, die, shoot, 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 bam, boom. That's everything Call of Duty World War II is. Shooting, dying, shooting, dying. The game that I really enjoyed was Brothers in Arms. And even the bad one, the one that was signed in Arnhem, I really enjoyed that. Get Bender Brothers. It really played out in using your strategy at your advantage, flanking the enemy and all that sort of stuff. And the old Call of Duty still had that idea in there. And it was not all action, all choreographed and programmed to do stuff. And what I really hate in it, in all Call of Duties, you can just finish a level without shooting the gun and killing any enemies. You just have to hit the waypoints. So you have to duck to cover, then run to the other point of cover. Your teammates kill them or they just run away, and that's the old game. You just have to duck into cover. Get to the next point of cover, and that's Call of Duty. Yeah, Ghost was horrible. I bought Ghost, and I already knew it was terrible. But not that terrible. It was ghastly, awful, and ugh. Michael Bay sludge. It really, if Michael Bay was making a video game, that's the video game. Yeah, Battlefield 1 is also like that. You have to hit the waypoints in that game, the programmed waypoints in that game, and the enemies will just disappear. It's not even challenging anymore. Why is it programmed like that? I really hate it. It's awful. It's not a video game. It's what Michael Bay thinks is a video game. It's horrible. But yeah, I'm going to log off. I hope you have a awesome Wednesday evening, night or day, wherever you are, or morning, maybe Thursday morning, maybe, I don't know, maybe night. So, and I will see you in my next stream. I'm going to do another stream because I have Christmas vacation right now, and I'm basically going to I bought a gigantic box of made 135 scale models and dioramas, and I'm going to unbox that box. I have two boxes full of them, all Tigers, Panzer IVs, Churchill tanks, Sherman tanks, and I'm going to show that to you guys. I'm going to unbox that box with you guys together on a live stream. I think that's pretty fun to do. I have seen a few of these models already. They're not in a great state. Some are missing parts. Others are broken because they've been in boxes in an attic or somewhere. I got a few models from a guy that was sick of modeling, and just started doing something else and he wanted to get rid of those models, so I took them over. Another few models are from an old man in his 80s and he didn't feel like making anything less, so I got there to buy a 1/16 scale T-34 and some paints, and he gave me a box full of 1/35 scale model tanks. So yeah, I was pretty happy with that, and a lot of dioramas also. Yeah, pre-built 1/35 armor. Yeah, a lot of Germans, and a dragon wagon. I saw a dragon wagon in there, so I'm pretty hyped for the dragon wagon. So I'm going to show you that maybe tomorrow or Friday. I have to take a look-see. But I will see you then in the next live stream. So say goodbye, everybody. Say goodbye. Thank you, Lee. And all you also a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year to everybody. And I will see you later. Goodbye.